Well, hopefully that can be sorted out as quickly as possible. Now let's see what's happening in the courts. The lawyers to the eight people suspected to be behind the brutal attack on Works and Transport Minister General Katumba Wamala are seeking a court order to treat the suspects for the injuries which they claim was inflicted on them by security agencies during their arrest. Geoffrey Turiamo Sima, the suspect's lawyer, made the request during the mention of this case at the Nakawa Chief Magistrate's Court today. We have more. Suspected to have been behind the assassination attempt on Works Minister General Katumba Wamala were this morning expected to appear before the Nakawa Chief Magistrate's Court for the first mention of their case. However, due to the prevailing COVID-19 situation, they appeared via Zoom. Despite their absence, their relatives turned up in large numbers to witness the mention of the case against their loved one. Upon the commencement of the court session, prosecution confessed that they needed more time to carry out investigations and thus sought an adjournment. Shortly before the adjournment, the suspect's lawyer revealed that the suspects have injuries inflicted on them by security operatives during the time of arrest, yet prison facilities do not have the expertise to treat these injuries, despite an earlier court directive issued to Kitalia prisons to have the suspects treated. Turiamo Sima therefore asked the court to issue an order to have the eight suspects accessed and treated for their injuries by the African Center for the Treatment and Rehabilitation of Torture Victims.
The instance of that, Your Honor, is basically because Luzira and Ochitalia don't have specialized doctors to assess and treat torture victims.
When asked about the progress of the treatment of the suspects, the prosecutor was skeptical whether the suspects were indeed treated or not.
He was ordered this. Not ordered for him to be taken
for him to be taken. Unfortunately, I also just got to this fight this morning.
Bujiri Municipality Member of Parliament and also lawyer to the suspects, Asuman Basalirwa, condemned the arrest and charging of the suspects without completing investigations.
It is really very sad that we come to court, people have been arrested at their own remand, and the idea is that investigations are still ongoing. An investigation led prosecution has many disadvantages, Your Honor.
The lawyers asked the court to permit the suspects to speak to some of their relatives who were in court, and this was granted by presiding magistrate Ponciano Oduoli.
You can have some 5 minutes to interact with the persons. So we do it, we must bear in mind.
Among other demands made is to allow the suspects' lawyers to visit them in prison to have them assent to signatures on their bail application. However, this application awaits court's decision on August 17th when the case will come back for mention.
When we appear today, we informed the court that the last time we appeared, court had ordered that the prison authorities together with the state should present medical reports or health status reports of all the accused persons. Unfortunately, that has not happened today. Now, our prayers today were, one, that prisons and all court orders that all the accused persons be treated and assessed by doctors from SCTV.
The charges are linked to the attempted assassination of the Minister of Works and Transport, General Edward Katumba Wamala, on 1st June 2021, which attack resulted in the death of General Katumba's daughter Brenda Nantongo and driver Sergeant Haruna Kayondo along Kisota Road in Kisasi. The government also alleges that the eight suspects are answerable for the murder of Major Muhammad Chigundu and his bodyguard, Sergeant Stephen Mukasa, Andrew Felix Kawesi and his driver, Godfrey Mambewa, and bodyguard, Kenneth Erao. Story by Rachel Nachiwala.